There you go. Oh my gosh! Will you guys be quiet? Hey, what's up you guys? So today, we're gonna be feeding some of the juvenile tarantulas. So, yep, let's start off today's feeding video with the cobalt blue, which I thought she'd be out. She's usually out, but now she is inside there. There, you can see her feet over there. Some nice cobalt blue feet. But yeah, let's toss in a cricket into this hole and hopefully she takes it for us. Wait, no, I only want one. What? Get off! Stop saving your friend. You can't save your friend. You can try, but you can't. Come here, girl. Oh, no. Cricket, you're not going anywhere. You're going into this hole. Oh, she took it. Yep, definitely took it. There we go. Well, not the best start to this video, but let's hope the next tarantula will give us a nice takedown. Be quiet! That's how you make crickets keep quiet. Anyways, next up we have the... Oh, started. Yep, you guys started. Whatever. Anyways, our next tarantula is this beautiful, beautiful pumpkin patch. The Haplopus species Columbia large. No, please don't go in. No. Okay, I'll get you a cricket. Please stay out. Oh, there we go. Please stay out, okay? Please stay out. Don't go in. Here you go. Oh my gosh! Okay, that was super quick. What was that? Beautiful takedown though. Should have been the first clip of this video. It'd be like such a perfect start to the video, but second is fine too. No problem. Beautiful tarantula. Check out that butt. By the way, if you're hearing sounds in the background, it's these guys. Super annoying. All right, so here is the Pteranochilus murinus, tan color form. The Usambara or the OBT. OBTs are Pteranochilus murinus as well, but this one isn't orange. OBT stands for orange baboon, but yeah, this one's not orange. But anyways, let's drop this cricket in and see her pounds. Whoa, that is very unlike of her. Okay, are you in pre-molt? Do you not want your cricket? Okay, I'm gonna have to take out the cricket because if you molt and... Oh, you wanna get it? Yeah, as I was saying, if you molt and the cricket's still in, the cricket could possibly eat you, so it's either you take the cricket or I take the cricket. You decide. Okay, so looks like I'm taking the cricket. Oh, okay. Okay, fine. You take the cricket then. You take the cricket. Next up is Pteranochilus cordatus, the Kilimanjaro mustard baboon. Oh, I think I missed the attack again. Yeah, I hope I didn't miss this one, but yeah, I think I missed this one. Sorry. This is the same genus as the OBT, Pteranochilus. Definitely get this one if you haven't got one in your collection. As you can see, they are quite heavy webbers and they do perfectly fine when the substrate is damp or even dry. So yeah, this tarantula is awesome. And as you can see, the mat that she does on the ground, the wet mat, that's pretty cool. She just lays down this layer of mat and just lays on it. I mean, she doesn't burrow or anything, she just chills on it, so that's pretty cool. Alright, this one I'm gonna have to be a little bit more cautious because this is the Kilobrachis huahini, the Asian fawn. Very fast species. She can just bolt out anytime and that will not be fun. And you know, I shouldn't be talking like right now, I should just drop this in and cover it because yeah, you don't want to mess with this girl. Alright, the cricket is going to die very soon. Oh, and there we go. Yep. I just jumped a little bit over there, but that was an awesome takedown. You guys gotta agree. Definitely get the Kilobrachis genus. You remember Kilobrachis kingcrichon? Those guys are crazy as well. Superb eaters. Very good reflexes. A slight movement just like this. I mean, she was crouched up at the side. Just a slight movement and she just pounced on it. Wow. Guys, if you're into Old World and you don't have a Kilobrachis, go and get yours right now because these guys, you can't go wrong with them. I mean, apart from them being crazy, but I guarantee you, if you like Old Worlds, you will like these guys. Alright, so here is my Phonopelma by Coloratum, the Mexican bloodleg, I believe. And I really hope that she will not go in because I want to get her out to feed. Because, I mean, she has made... I'll show you guys later. I'll feed her first. Come on, girl. Are you hungry? Yeah. Okay, come on out. Come on out. We just want to see you. Okay, there we go. Beautiful. Well, she didn't come out fully, but you guys saw how she looks like. I mean, she is one heck of a gorgeous tarantula. Oh yeah, and the thing that I wanted to show you is that she has made a beautiful burrow over here. Like, it literally almost goes all around. Oh my goodness. I'm sorry. I mean, this burrow, this side just collapsed down. This is what happens when you have them on coconut fiber, and the coconut fiber gets a little bit dry. It tends to collapse down on burrows. If if you want it to keep burrow steady, you're gonna have to keep it constantly damp. But yeah, that is the burrow. Like, it goes all the way around here. Pretty dang cool. But yeah, I'm not gonna mess with this girl's burrow anymore because I've already collapsed one side, so
I'm sorry, forgive me.
You guys remember my tree frog? Yep, she is doing really, really well. And let's see if she eats for us. I'm not sure if she'll be hungry today. I mean, you guys wanted an update on her, and well, she's doing pretty well. But she doesn't always eat, so if she doesn't eat here, I'm sorry. Well, at least you guys saw her. She's still with me and she's doing super duper well. Here is our next tarantula, the Ceratogyra sandari, Namibia horned baboon. This one usually doesn't take life for some reason. If it does now, it's the first time she takes life. But usually I feed her pre-killed prey. And well, she's doing... Whoa, okay, whoa, okay. What was that? You see, like I mentioned, she doesn't really eat live prey, but come on, you know you can do it. Yep, come on, just grab it. Probably needs a little bit of encouragement. Okay, are you not interested in the cricket? I know you are, because you tried to get it, but then it struggled, and then you're like, nope, nope, nope. But I'm pretty sure you want it, so there you go, good girl. Nope, cricket, I didn't say you are a good girl, you're a bad girl. But tarantula is a good girl, and you, bad girl, you're gonna be eaten by the good girl. Oh man, come on. And the thing is, I don't want to leave the cricket in with her because the cricket can harm the tarantula. So I'm gonna have to make sure that she eats. And if she doesn't eat, I'm gonna have to take the cricket out and maybe pre-kill it. Yeah, I'm gonna have to pre-kill this cricket for her because she doesn't eat live prey for some reason. Many of you may argue that,
oh, tarantulas, they eat live prey. And since you don't feed them live prey, you are making them not be like in the wild.
But I'm sorry, tarantulas gotta eat. If she doesn't eat live prey, I'll pre-kill her prey. Whether I'm spoiling her or not, I don't care, as long as she eats. So now I'm gonna pre-kill this cricket, and well, don't watch. Alright, it's pre-killed now. I just knocked it off, and well, I'll just drop it here. Yeah, okay, I'll leave it over there, and then we will come back, and hopefully she would have taken it for us. Alright, next up, let's see if this one wants to eat. It looks like it's in the burrow somewhere, but I don't know, let's check it out. Oh, there, you can see the butt over there. It's just butt showing us right there. No, no fetish for tarantula butts, but yeah, okay, let's go. So this is my Orphanacus philippinus, the Philippine tangerine or Philippine orange, whatever you want to call it. This one also usually eats dead prey, but I don't know. It's always worth a shot, right? So come on. Whoa. Oh gosh, okay. Yep, I think it took it. Did it take it? I'm not quite sure, but... Oh yeah, it did. It did. There we go. And we missed the attack once again, but, you know, that wasn't my fault because the tarantula was already in her burrow. I mean, as long as she's taken it and the cricket is not hidden in there without me being able to find it, I mean, that's dangerous for the tarantula. So, as long as the tarantula takes it, I'm happy. I'm super happy, so... Yep, let's move on to the next one. Oh, why does everyone have to be hidden in the burrow? This is my Davis Pantelloris, the Guatemalan tiger rump. I mean, if you guys are wondering why tiger rump, look at the rump, I mean the butt. It is, I think they should call it the tiger butt instead. This is the tiger butt. Tiger rump, tiger butt, whatever. And it looks like a tiger, whatever, because that is a tiger butt. And well, let's grab a cricket and just toss it in and hopefully she comes out for us. Cricket, go in the burrow. No, not here. Oh. All right, I've got this angle over here. Oh yeah, beautiful. There we go. So that's the attack from the Davis Pantelloris. Okay, yeah, maybe not a good idea to leave this open. I'm probably just gonna close it because I don't want this old world coming out. It's not fun if she decides to bolt sandaries or super fast. Yeah, I know you are super fast, but I'm not gonna be taking chances. Okay, so in you go and stay in. Yep, we just want to see if you get the cricket. Please get the cricket. Come on. You guys remember my forest scorpion? Yep, I just fed him a cricket. Sorry, I didn't film it. Yeah, but he's eating it and he is really... Oh, okay, calm down, okay. He is definitely enjoying that cricket. So yeah, I don't want to stress him too much. Okay, calm down. Okay, let's move on to the next tarantula. Oh my gosh, this guy. Okay, so this is my David Bowie Huntsman spider. Let's get her a cricket and see if she takes it for us. Here is a nice, freshly molted, juicy cricket. Let's... Where are you going? Where do you think you're going to get the back like that. Alright, so let's just give it to her. I mean, I'm gonna try to tongue feed her. So let's see if she takes it, okay? Well, hey, here is the cricket. Do not want the cricket. It's freshly molted. Hey, cricket, behave. Oh, she senses it. She senses it. Oh, here we go. Oh, no. Why don't you want the cricket? No, you don't want the cricket. Do you want me to like drop it in or something? Oh yeah, by the way, that's her egg sack. She just ripped it apart. I have no idea why, probably infertile. I'll do a video on that. This girl also only eats pre-kill, unfortunately, but I mean, since she's a juvenile, I thought of just showing her to you guys. She is my Samopoyas pulcher, the Panama blonde. Not really sure if the camera focused right there, but I mean, let's just try to give her a cricket, okay? If she eats this one, it'll be her first time eating alive. So let's see, they're gonna come up for us. Oh my gosh, cricket. No. Ugh. Come here. Do you want a live cricket? Nope. See, she just runs away. I mean, she just walks away. So yeah, I know my tarantulas very well. The ones that eat pre-kill, when I say they eat only pre-kill, they eat only pre-kill. So yep, whatever makes them eat. Oh no, don't go in. I want to get you on footage. Okay, this is the Chaco Goldenie. Grandma stole a poker piece. Oh, there, here she comes. Oh, cricket, you better run. Ma'am, never mind. Yeah, I told you to run. I mean, I was a little bit late, but I told you to run. Come on, you're supposed to run. But anyways, let's get another one. And okay, I give you a chance to run, okay? You better run. Run. I said run. Don't walk, you slumber slow little... Yep, there we go. I see, run. Wow, you're supposed to run that way, not this way. Genius. Crickets are genius. Probably the smartest animals on this planet. How are they even still alive till today? Oh my goodness, what is that? Okay, I'll stop now. Yep, that is one nasty looking water dish. New watering video coming up, stay tuned. But yeah, let's feed this girl. Hopefully she eats for us. Oh, beautiful. And I missed the attack. Okay. Let's grab another one since she is hungry. This Chaco Goldenie doesn't always eat as well, but when she eats, she eats. Hey, get off, cricket, get off. There we go. Gentle one for the second time, but I mean, as long as she eats, right? Awesome beginner species. You guys want to get into tarantulas? Do consider the Chaco Goldenie. It was my first tarantula as well. All right, so that is pretty much all of my juvenile tarantula. These guys are slinks, and yep, these are slinks as well. So let's just, I mean, I have another, how many crickets? Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 small ones, so let's feed all of them to Death Nugget, shall we? And for those of you who are new and unfamiliar, Death Nugget is my Goliath bird eater, which is in there. You can see her legs. So let's just feed her some of the crickets.
I've got to leave, guys. Leaf is here to save the day.
All right, let's try to get her out. Okay, please don't attack so hard. Come on. Okay. Calm down. Got some crickets for you. You want some crickets? Come on. Okay, she's not happy. She's definitely not happy. Also partly because this leaf is really big and she probably think it's a big prey item. I mean, a big predator. See, I'm even getting confused with prey and predator.
Prey is something she eats, predator is something that eats her.
Yep, so she may think that is something that eats her. So that is why she's being quite defensive. And well, oh yeah, one way that you can see her. If we come around this side, yep, there we go. You can see her right there. She does not look happy at all. All right, so I guess we'll be feeding these crickets to this tarantula over here. There's the Pamphobetus cf antennas. Can't find my tongs, so let's just pour all of this in and watch the feeding frenzy. Let's go. Oh. Okay, you get it. Did you get one? Oh, this cricket is so doomed. Oh, there's another cricket over here. Oh gosh, these guys are so doomed, I tell you. Whoa. One more move forward and you are gone. Wow. Oh my gosh. Yep, that guy's panicking. All right, let's get you out so you can stop panicking. And I mean, you can just, let's just get it over and done with.
Put you out of your misery.
Come on, out of your misery. Oh. Come on, let's go. Okay. Okay, there we go. Beautiful. So there's the second or third one. I'm not really sure, but she's definitely taken quite a few. And there are small ones running around and she will find it, so no worries. So guys, that will be it for this video. I hope my voice came out okay for this one because it's like really late at night. So yeah, hope everything's okay. But regardless, as always, if you like this video, be sure to thumbs it up. If you didn't, feel free to thumbs it down if you're new to this channel. Subscribe, notification bell, you guys know what to do. But yeah, like I mentioned, that will be it for this video. So you guys take care and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.
See guys, told you she'll take pre-kill. You can't really see the cricket, but she has definitely taken that cricket.
Oh, and by the way, if my voice sounds a little bit different, it's because I'm in my bedroom. And well, the animal room, it has my echo. Echo keeps bouncing against the walls. Oh, whoa, okay, calm down. No, see, there we go. We can see the cricket now. I'm sorry, you can go and eat your cricket. I just want to show, okay, I'm sorry. Yeah, see guys, don't worry. She'll grab it back. But yeah, as I was saying, my animal room, the echo is just crazy because it's a really small room and the walls are all like packed up together, so my voice just starts bouncing all over the place. So that is why my voice sounds different in this room, my bedroom, and my animal room.